If we estimate the long regression, where we regress wage on the degree and manager, then we basically control for this channel, and our coefficient, our estimated coefficient beta 1L, only captures this direct effect from obtaining the university degree on the wage, not the effect that is goes through the channel that it's more likely to become a manager. If instead we estimate the short regression, if we only regress wage on obtaining a university degree, we estimate with beta 1S hat the total effect of obtaining the university degree on the wages. Yeah, and in most studies, one typically is interested in the total causal effect through all the possible channels by which the university degree could affect the wages. So if we are interested in this, and that was the question in the quiz also, we would estimate the short regression. So we would add these manager variables only if we are interested in the direct effect from degree of wage that doesn't work through the channel that having a university degree makes it more likely to become a manager. So if you think about whether adding a control variable or not, we really should maybe make such a graph in your mind. Think about what is the relationship between this variable and the main variable you are interested in. If it's a channel variable, you probably don't want to add it to your regression unless you're really sure that you want to ignore that particular channel when you estimate the effect. Let me explain a bit more why it is so hard in reality to estimate the causal effect from obtaining a university degree on your wages. The problem is that we have variables that affect both the likelihood to get a degree and your wages, like for example, intelligence. So you would suspect that people who are more intelligent are more likely to go to university and are more likely to get a degree, but having a high intelligence will typically also directly positively affect your wage. So if we would just run the question of wage on degree, a short regression where we don't control for intelligence, basically we wouldn't really estimate the causal effect from degree on wage only, but we also would have the indirect effect that people who have a degree are on average more intelligent and also get higher wages. So we would have a positive bias. Our estimate for the coefficient of the degree would be systematically larger than the direct causal effect from the degree on wage. That's good if you want to make advertisements that you should all go to university and obtain a degree, because kind of if you don't control for stuff like intelligence, it seems as if the degree has an even bigger impact on your wages than it actually has. But if you really want to do science and estimate this causal effect, we would need to deal with this problem. And ideally, we would have data for all these possible variables we don't have observed, which are often called unobserved confounders, so because they confound our estimate of the causal effect. But it's really tricky to get data for this. So can we really measure intelligence? Yeah, well, we may have data of an intelligent test score, or maybe the grades in school, which are a proxy for this. But there are many more variables that affect both the likelihood to get a degree and the wage, so how motivated you are, maybe your parents' incomes, your parents' connections. There are a lot of factors that can basically lead to indirect correlation between having a degree and your wage. And often in reality, it's really not possible to get data for all this sort of possible confounders. So estimating real causal effects is often very, very difficult. And sometimes one can use strategies like running a randomized experiment. So if you could just throw a dice who is allowed to go to university or not. And sometimes we have those random elements if you have a limited number of seats and you don't want to assign them poorly via the grade. You may use some random mechanisms that can help to estimate causal effects. Or there are other strategies like instrumental variable estimation or difference in difference estimation, which we will see later in a chapter, or synthetic control approach, which we will also learn. And they are basically the idea is to overcome this problem of unobservable confounders and estimate causal effects. So we will explore some of those in more detail later in the course. But for now, that's enough on this topic. We will go back to our Wein example.